when I was 16. I did indeed wind up traveling with Duke Ellington as a dancer for one of his suites. One day, we're almost at the end of the tour, and Mr. Ellington called me into his dressing room, and he says, sing something for me. And I looked around, I said, there's no piano. And he said, you don't need a piano. We can all sing. We all got rhythm, don't we? And so that was a challenge. And so I sang everything I heard the lead singer sing. And that was all his music. When I finished, he said, do you still have that little gold dress you wore before we left, the party we gave before we left? And I said, oh, yes, I even have the shoes, the gold shoes. He said, you're going to have to go on tonight. And I said, but, and he said, the band singer got, fell deathly ill, very, very ill, and she had to go home. And I thought, this is my big chance. After I got through with the chills and the nervousness, and so I went on, and the great Duke Ellington is playing for me. You can't, it's like being on a cloud, floating on a cloud. You can do no wrong. And I found myself just loving it. And he finally came to me afterward. He said, you were wonderful, but please let that microphone go and be yourself. He says, She holds on to the microphone because she's so nervous. She can't. She'd fall down if she couldn't. That's why she holds on to the mic. Be yourself. And that's the best advice I ever got.